It is Thursday, January 10th, and the golf cart is finished. Got the ARC Racing Governor Bypass throttle plate, ARC Racing cone air filter adapter with a 1¾-inch K&N filter, hence the decal. Also got some exhaust wrap for that bend there because it gets really hot and likes to cook the wood, as well as there were a few little breaches in the welds for when the material didn't fill in. So that's good. This is the final setup. Of course, for whatever reason, my filter didn't come with a choke hold, lever hold, so lever came off. And at least I could still, you know, use the choke this way, even though it's kind of annoying. But I am able to start it cold without choke now that the governor is removed. So no need to open the friggin' thing every single time I want to start it. So now I'll just do a walk around. As you can see from the outside, looks like a normal golf cart. But little do they know. I even got one of these friggin' things. Of course, got my tack. I haven't hooked up the lights yet because my battery is kind of messed up. And besides from this high-profile exhaust setup, it looks like a normal golf cart. But I got a crack up here. Probably can't see it that well, but my uncle was riding on the back of this thing. He was holding onto the bars here, and that kind of cracked the plastic because he was drunk. So that squeaks a bit, but whatever. I'll fix it eventually. Everything is assembled now, ready to go. Electric start's hooked up, charging coil is hooked up, kill switch, of course, is hooked up. Oh, and for those who are new to this setup, it is a GX200 Honda copy by Carol Stream. Works very well. Overhead valve. As you can see, 16 horsepower, but probably a little more than that due to this intake and exhaust setup. Maybe 16 and a half, 17. New fuel pump. Because the old one was all, that little baffle in there, little diaphragm, was all clogged up with gummy stuff. So this one I had got a new one. And only drawback to this, it might be different with your golf cart if it isn't a club car, but as you can see, about the first half pull of the throttle does not engage the carburetor until you press it a little more than half, and as you can see, starts to move, then you're good to go. Still got the pull start on it, and the crappy, yes, crappy Comet 94C clutch. But let's start it up, hear the engine. You see, got the kill switch hooked up to the on switch. I can still use the factory key. Probably have to pump it a little bit because it's cold. Let's see, make sure I'm zoomed out here. There we go. Settles around 1200 or so. Exhaust does rattle a little bit, but that's all right. New rear shocks as well. So now, let's get a bit of an exhaust clip, why don't we? as you can hear, runs very well. Nice pop off. Everything is secured under here. Now, let's pop her and drive. It actually, the governor wouldn't let the idle drop below 1800. But now that that's bypassed, you can shift the gears since the clutch isn't engaging. But yeah, let's go. It's very well, a little bit louder than the stock engine. You hear that roof vibrating. Let's do, I guess, a launch so you can see where the clutch is engaged and all that. All right, here we go. Absolutely there when you need it. Get a little sideways, no problem. See, runs very well. Stock engine revs pretty good. I'm gonna have to put a little thicker oil in it. I got 530 weight. Since the governor's off, I'm gonna want to make sure I have optimal lubrication. Yep, this is basically the final update of the swap on the Club Car Golf Cart. I will probably be making little changes here and there, like, you know, the lights, little things. Yep, that's the finished product. All turned out very well. It's fast, not too loud, and the power's there when you need it, and it cruises just like it was when it was stock. Thanks for watching. I will see you guys next time.